Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Metro. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_005_DIAB_M. You can also download this file from the website. Zoom in into this area and right click the wall and select Grid Similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Press Escape twice to get out of the command. Select the wall and click the witness line of the temporal dimension line. Move this witness line to the core face of this wall. Change its value to 1950 mm. Press Enter. Now right click the reference plane and select Grid Similar. Go to Draw Panel and select the Pick Line button. Change your offset distance to 2100 mm. Press Enter. Offset this reference. Select the core face of this wall to offset it down, and select the core face of this wall to offset it to the right. Click on this circle and move it right up. Click the Modify button. Now zoom in into this area. Go to the Modify tab and Modify panel and select the Split Element tool. Check the Delete Inner Segment and click this face and this face. Because the Delete Inner Segment is checked, Revit automatically deletes this object. Click the Modify button. Select the dimension command in the Measure panel. Select the face of this wall. You see, we just revealed that we don't have the actual measurements we need in this area. Now click to place a dimension for the moment and click the Modify button. Select the dimension command again. Try to dimension and see this wall, this and this. Move up and click to place the dimension. Click the Modify button. Now click on this wall and change its value to 4200. Press Enter. So we need to update all of these other values based on this value. Now select this wall. Draw a dimension from this wall to this wall. Click to place its dimension. Click the Modify button. Select this wall. Change its value to 7200 mm. Press Enter. Click this arrow to flip this wall outside. Select the dimension. Click the Edit Witness Line. Click this face and click this face. Click and in an empty area. Select this wall. Select this dimension line and click the witness line to move it into this face. Select this wall. Change the value to 675. Press Enter. Select this wall. Change the value to 675. Press Enter. Select this wall. Change the value to 2550 mm. Press Enter. Select this wall and change this value to 2000 mm. Press Enter. Now zoom out into this area. Select this wall. Change this value to 3000. Press Enter. Select this wall and change this value to 5550 mm. Press Enter. Click the flip arrow and select the dimension. Select the dimension and click the witness line. Click on this face to remove that witness line and click this other core face to place the witness line. Click in an empty area to end this witness line command. Go to the quick access window and click the save button. Sometimes when you create an object during the creation process, you may find an error. You have to be careful and correct that error before you proceed. Now zoom in into this area. We need to reconstruct this area because now, as you look at this corner, is not aligned the way we expect it to be. To do that, select this wall and hit delete. Select this wall, hit delete. Select this wall, hit delete. Select the align dimension command, select the face of this wall, the face of this wall, and this wall. Click to face dimension. Make sure that the value from the reference line to the reference plane to each wall is 1500 mm. Now select this reference plane, the second one, and select this, and make sure that the value is 1500 mm. Press the modify button. Now right click the wall, select grid similar. In the drop panel, click the circumscribe polygon and change the number of side to 8. Change the shell line to core face interior. Now click on this area to start the wall command and move, and click on this reference plane. Rivet complete because we have some walls that overlap each other. Click the modify button. Use a window selection to select this wall. Hold down the control key, select this wall, and this wall. Hit delete on your keyboard. Zoom out into this area. Right click this wall and select grid similar. In the drop panel, select the circumscribed polygon and click on the center of this reference plane. Move the mouse cursor and click on the face of this wall. Again, rivet complete. Click the modify button. Select this wall, this wall, this wall, this wall, and this wall. Hit delete on your keyboard. Select this wall and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the modify panel and select trim extend to corner. Select this wall, select this wall, and this wall. Click the modify button. Zoom out to see the results. Now right click into this wall and select grid similar. Make sure that the chain option is checked. Draw a wall from this point. Move inside and draw. Move up and draw. Move to the lower left. The dimension isn't important at this moment. Click. Move up and click. Move into this direction. Click and move down to this area and click. Click the modify button. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Zoom in into this area. Click on this face, this face, this face, and this face. Place the dimension. Click on this face and this face. Place the dimension. Click on this face and this face. Click an interior to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Now select this wall and change this value to 1350. Press enter. Zoom out, select this wall, change value to 7650 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, change this value to 3150 mm. Press enter. Zoom out, select this wall and change this value to 750 mm. Press enter. Now select the dimension command in the measure panel. Zoom in into this area. Select this face of this wall, click to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change this value to 3000 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, change the value to 7200 mm. Press enter. Select this wall, click on this witness line and change the value to 5400 mm. Press enter. Flip the wall outside and click the temporal dimension to this, move it to this face. Zoom out in into this area, select this wall, change this value to, select this wall, flip it outside, click on the witness line and move it to this face. Change this value to 4200 mm. Press enter. Zoom out to see the results so far. Select the dimension command and dimension from this face to this face. If the result is 3000, it means you are in the right point. Click to place. Now click the modify button. Right click into this wall and select grid similar. Draw a wall from this point, move to the vertical direction and draw. Move into this direction, draw another wall and move down to complete this wall. Click the modify button. Select the dimension command, dimension the face of this wall and the face of this wall. select the face of this wall, this wall, this wall. Click to increase the dimension. Click the modify box. Select this wall, changes value to 1800 millimeter. Press enter. Select this wall, change the value to 5250 millimeter. Press enter. Click select dimension command. Click the face of this wall and the face of this wall. Place the dimension. Make sure that it says 9900 millimeter. Select the face of this wall and the face of this wall. Click to place the dimension. Select the modify button. Select the this wall and change this value to 2000. Change this value to 2000 millimeter. Press enter. Click out to deselect the wall. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend single element. Select the face of this wall and select this wall. Click the modify button. Right click the reference plane and select grid similar. Select the pick line button. Change the offset to 750 and select the face of this wall and the face of this wall. Click the modify button. Select right click the wall and select grid similar. Start a wall from this intersection to this intersection. Select trim extend to corner. Select this wall, this wall, this wall, this wall. Click the modify button. Zoom out to see the results. Now use a window selection to select everything in the project and click the filter button. Check none and select dimension. Apply, click OK and hit delete on your keyboard. Click on constrain. Select use a window selection again. Select check none, uncheck all and select OK. Hit delete on your keyboard. All the reference planes have been deleted except those that are pinned. Go to the navigation bar and select the zoom to fit command. You can also type ZF on your keyboard. Go to the file tab. Hover the mouse cursor to save as project. Rename this project to 00_006_DIAB_M. Click the save button to save this project. Alright, we just completed the floor plan of our project. But before we end this video, we need to grid two more walls into this area. Right click this wall and select grid similar. Start a wall from this point and move into this direction. Press escape. Start another wall from this point to this direction. Press escape. Right click the reference plane, grid similar, select the pick line button and change the offset distance to 300 millimeter. Press enter. Select the face of this wall. Click the modify button. Select the reference plane and make sure that the value is 300 millimeter. Go to the trim extend multiple element. Select this reference plane, click this wall and this wall. Click the modify button. Select the reference plane and hit delete on your keyboard. Now select this wall and move the weakness line to the edge of this wall. Change this value to 900 millimeter. Press enter. And select this wall. Move the weakness line to the face of this wall and change the value to 900 millimeter. Press enter. Click in an empty area to end the command. Click the zoom to fit command. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Alright, we're going to end this video. In the next tutorial, we'll start to place the door family in our project. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share this to your friends. If you have any question or suggestion, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.